What if I told you that by the time you leave here today, you will forever change how you see every place you go? Why do you like some places and not others? Maybe you've wondered why your own town couldn't be more like that place. Today, you'll learn why and what you can do about it. I'm here to challenge you to have a little curiosity, be bold, and be creative. The best places for us to start are our own neighborhoods. To begin, I'm going to ask that you close your eyes and think of your neighborhood. You may see your house, your street, even a few blocks. If you live in a rural community, you may see your whole town. It's important to think of how you define your neighborhood. Open your eyes. Now that you've identified your neighborhood boundaries, think of one challenge, big or small. What are some possible solutions? What can be done? Who might be able to help? As you were thinking about your neighborhood challenge and some possible solutions, how many of you started off by saying, they should really do something about this? They should put in speed bumps to slow traffic down. They could do a better job of picking up the trash. This is the shift in thinking that can change everything. There is no they. There is only we. Let me explain. You may have already called them to complain about your issue, but you may have experienced that they just don't seem to care about it as much as you do. That's because cities and maintenance departments have limited resources, so your challenge gets prioritized behind other more complex issues that can threaten public health or even public safety. They just need bigger challenges. But these small improvements and incremental changes, they can make a world of difference in a neighborhood. And we can do something that they can't. We can work together to improve our neighborhoods ourselves. Let's try it out together. Let's imagine a place together, such as where we are here in Lafayette. And let's pretend now that we're now all neighbors and this is now our shared neighborhood. As we go through this together, I want you to remember your own neighborhood and think of how it can be improved. Where do we start? You're about to learn what makes a place truly great. Great places share three basic elements: safety, comfort, and identity. But in order for a community to understand how to use these elements to improve their community, it's important to break them down even more. Let's begin with safety. Our shared neighborhood here feels safe because of streetlights and plenty of people around. It feels safe to walk and bike because of wide sidewalks and slower traffic. Does your neighborhood feel safe? What elements are missing? Now let's get comfortable in our neighborhood. We feel comfortable in this shared neighborhood because of shade from trees and awnings, plus inviting benches, bike racks, bus stops, and trash cans. Does your neighborhood feel comfortable? What amenities are missing? Finally, my favorite, neighborhood identity. We can see the identity of our neighborhood here because of streetlight banners, murals, inviting parks and gateways, plus music and events that bring people together. Does your neighborhood reflect its residents and identity? How could it do more? You see, places don't just happen by accident. They're the sum of many smaller choices and projects, and we, together as neighbors, can start addressing some of those smaller challenges together. Let's come back together as neighbors and go back into our shared neighborhood. Using what we just learned, how can we think about one thing our shared neighborhood needs? We talked about good lighting on the main street, but it's still a little dark on the side streets. Maybe more street lights would make it feel safer. But how can we address this ourselves? Maybe we have neighbors here who are on the side streets, who would be willing to host a light pointed to illuminate the street. I bet we have neighbors who are architects, designers, electricians who can help. I bet some of you would be willing to get the word out, help with installation, pick up supplies. Look at what we've just done. We've made a plan to install our very own streetlights. By thinking creatively, we can see solutions that they sometimes can't see. You see, I'm someone who can't stop looking for opportunities in places. I'm constantly thinking of creative solutions and how to do a lot with a little bit. I always start out the same way we just did. I draw a boundary, I identify the assets, I prioritize the needs, and then I start talking to the neighbors. How can we use what we have to address the safety, comfort, and identity of where we live? I want to share a real-life example with you, not just an exercise. And I want to warn you, it's going to sound a little bit crazy at first and almost impossible, but that'll just show you what a little blind optimism can do for you. In my town, Lafayette's most utilized park was missing something. It had most of the elements we already talked about, but it was missing that one identifiable asset that made it unlike anywhere else in the world. So we got creative. And of course, the only logical answer were 7-foot-tall concrete letters spelling Lafayette in the center of the park. The letters were meant to be painted and repainted and even serve as a play structure for our tiniest neighbors. But there was even more than that. The Y would be missing so that people could stand in the middle with their arms up and be the Y in Lafayette. Because people were why this place mattered. People were the Y in Lafayette that made it unlike anywhere else in the world. I told you it seemed crazy. It was. But it's okay to be bold and experiment in our own communities. With only this first sketch in my notebook, I started sharing it with neighbors I already knew. We started together talking to more neighbors, and soon, to my surprise, many of them were offering to help. One neighbor put us in touch with a contractor who gave us a quote and thus a fundraising goal. Another neighbor started selling letters to neighbors for $1,000 each, getting us halfway to our fundraising goal and launching a crowdfunding campaign. This effort did way more than raise money. It raised our sense of community ownership and our sense of identity. And that's only grown since installation. Remember, we did this as neighbors before we even went to them. We went to them with what we were willing to do ourselves. In turn, the city helped us with some of the installation, and they even let us put it on public property. And I'm happy to share this with you. Since then, kids climb all over the letters, and they have been painted and repainted. We've seen this place become the pinnacle of a great public space because it is now where our community both celebrates together and mourns together. Simply, it's where we come to be together. We didn't have all the answers when we started, but we took the first step. We got to know our neighbors by making a plan together. It doesn't matter if it's as simple as a streetlight or a homemade sign that says, "Slow down, kids at play," or as crazy as these concrete letters. It's a start at building community. With each success, no matter how small, we can celebrate together and even plan our next project. So you may be wondering when you get started, what happens when your city finds out what you're up to? Will they be supportive? Here's the secret. When you come with only a complaint, they'll just put you in queue with all the other complaints. But when you come together as neighbors with solutions and innovations, they're more willing to help you. You've just expanded your we to include them, and that's where the shift happens. These improvements seem impossible on your own. They are. But when we work together, we can do more. Every project I've ever worked on has built at least one new relationship, and I promise it will for you too. See, it's never about the mural or the park cleanup. It's about building relationships with neighbors. And when you care about your neighbors, you want to take care of them too. And now, you know how to take better care of the people and the place you love the most. We don't just have power as citizens. You have power as a citizen. Stretch into that power and become an engaged citizen. If not you and your neighbors for your own neighborhood, who will? And if not today, that you know how, when will you? You can let things happen to you and to your neighborhood, or you can make things happen. See the spaces around you as yours, because they are yours. Let's take ownership and take better care of each other by starting to take better care of our own neighborhoods.